HBCUs. Some of you all don't know, you know, what that is. From my followers, our subscribers, our people who just might come to my page, you know, and know like some of my background. I want to know, let you know some of my background. Q had just passed away. He's a former HBCU king. He's Mr. Harris. So I forgot what year. I want to say 09, I think. It may be 09, 010. That might be his year. Mr. Harris, but he just passed away 2 days ago. Really, just yesterday, for real. It was 2 days ago. 2 days ago, to a heart attack due to his injuries from a car accident he had prior a few years ago. So he had a heart attack, passed away. He was 32 years old. So the next couple of episodes gonna be dedicated to him. We've been watching some HBCU videos. This one is actually the year that I was heavily involved in HBCU. But I'm not in a video, but I am. Well, I was there at the event. So let's go. Today we're going to be watching, NASAP 2014 Student Leadership Institute. And I'm going to explain what that is real quick, because it's buffering right now. But NASAP Student Leadership Institute is a institute where student leaders from all other HBCUs, like kings and queens, SGA presidents, student activity board presidents, and stuff like that. They go to this one location and at a hosting HBCU. In this particular case, this was Maryland Eastern Shore. And we all came and we learned how to be a better student leader, and how can we be get like fresh ideas and new ideas, and that's really where we came to network and get to know each other as just people. And it was a good time. Learned a lot, met a lot of good people. This was before I was Greek, so I wasn't a Greek, so I was just a regular person. And I mean, I'm not saying a regular person, I'm just saying I was just not Greek. So we're going to be watching, in this presentation, this is people from Southern University and A&M College. This is their presentation. And this is what we're talking about. I'm going to set it up. And every year we go with our schools, but we all get assigned to a different, group. Within like the programs, like a group of people from like different schools can be a part of a group called Kumba. I think it's forgive me, I haven't been there in a while. So it's each group is based off like a symbolic, like Kwanzaa, different meanings. So this group, I'm not sure, I didn't even get a chance to watch the whole video, but this group is, I don't know, but you'll see what I'm talking about. In each group, you get to assign a topic of how we will fix a certain situation. And we have to come up, I think we have 10, this says 14 minutes, but it's some other things. I think you have a total of 10 minutes to present your topic in an interesting way, a creative way. So this is the group. So This is 2014 NASAP. So here we go.
I gotta go to work.
You don't have no job, Tommy.
How you gonna tell me I don't have a job?
What do you mean you gotta go
to work? I've been here for 42 years, work for 18 years. Don't tell me what I do. Okay, okay. You know what? Leave. Leave. You always walk out of my life. Leave. Son, I love you. Son, I love you. Good. Goodbye.
And I should be mad.
You know what? I'm not mad. Why should I be mad? It's not like I'm still 5 years old, sitting up every night, asking my mom and dad, when daddy's coming home, who needs it? You know what? He wasn't there teaching me how to shoot my first basket, but I learned, didn't I? And I got pretty good at it too, didn't I? I got through my first date without him. I learned how to drive. I learned how to shave. I had 19 great birthdays without him. He never even sent me a damn card. Hell with him! I ain't need him then and don't need him now. Now, you know what? I'm gonna get through college without him. I'm gonna get a great job without him. I'm gonna marry me a beautiful honey. I'm gonna be a better father than he ever was. Because I sure as hell don't need him for that. Because ain't a damn thing he could ever teach me about how to love my kids.
Yeah.
And imperative that we discover a brave and startling truth. And when we come to it, to the day of peacemaking, when we release our fingers from fists of hostility and allow the cool air to fill our palms, when we come to it, when the curtain falls on the minstrel show of hate, and faces suited with scorn are scrubbed clean, when battlefields and coliseums no longer rape our unique and particular sons and daughters, up from the bruised and bloody grass to lie in identical plots in foreign lands, when we come to it, then we must confess we did not the pyramids with their stones set in mysterious perfection, nor the gardens of Babylon hanging as eternal beauty in our collective memories, nor the Danube flowing of blue soul into Europe, neither Father Amazon nor Mother Mississippi, who without fame or nurture all creatures in the depths and on the shores. These are not the only wonders of this world. When we come to it, we, this people on this small and drifting planet, who reach daily for the bomb, the blade, the dagger, yet petition in the dark for tokens of peace. We, this people, on this moat of matter, in whose mouths abide cantankerous words that challenge our very existence. Yet out of those same mouths come songs of such exquisite sweetness that the heart falters in its labor and the body is quieted into awe. We, this people, on this wayward floating body, created on this earth, of this earth, have the power to fashion for this earth a land where every man and every woman can live freely without sanctimonious piety and without crippling fear. When we come to it, then we must confess that we are the possible. We are the miraculous, the true wonders of this world. That is when, and only we win. We come to it.
Precious Lord.
And our first place winner for the health awareness goes to the Green Group. Our first place winners in the case studies goes to Nia, social media.
The group is called Nia.
Feet in front of my seat, I like. They got me saying, oh.
Best, and now and stuff like that. Well, my first time going, it was at Maryland Eastern Shore. And the category of the most funniest male came up. And so I wasn't really equipped for like the winning thing. I was just happy to be there. So anyway, she named off the name who won. And she said, and the winner is Adrian. I said, I had like a mid stand. I did like when he had the Walker. Like that was the most embarrassing moment in my life. Everybody in my table told me to get up. People in my group told me to get up. And everybody was literally saying, "Oh, I didn't want it." Like, oh. I didn't know I was that funny. I'm like, "All right, wasn't me. Definitely somebody else." Yeah, that was wild. That was a wild experience. Then my time at that one, like it was a point where the president of Savannah University was in like we had an open session. You know, she had asked, she said, "I'm gonna name off the years for everybody that was founded, and y'all, you know, scream out your scream out your chant." All right, so. She was going out the years and years. By the time she got to our year, she said, 1857, I jumped up. Because I was trying to beat everybody else, you know, because I don't know who else was like down there. 1857, I popped up. I started yapping out, "I'm a blast, I'm a blast, I'm a blast." I went so fast, the people that were with me, they were so confused. They didn't know what I was saying. I was just like, and then I had stopped. Like, and then I had looked at them, so yeah, y'all go. They would say, "I love my age, I love my hips, I love my, you know, all that." Like, it was silent. I remember looking up and looking around, like, everybody was just looking at us. Even the president, she was just like, 19. I had some time, but I had some time. Yeah, but that's what age. I don't know if anybody else been there. People from St. Louis might not know I had an HBCU experience, but I experienced all of the HBCU. And that's a good term. And that's where the lights are. He came from. He was an HBCU king. So, Mr. Eric. So, I don't know if he ever wants to make that or not, but he actually placed, and it's a competition called HBCU King competition, and Q was one of the people who actually played. And he was so close, he was this close to winning. The first person from Arizona to ever, you know, be close, so close to winning. So, RIP King, he missed. Like, I can't even cry, because I just I can't believe, I literally just seen somebody, you know, like seeing them post on Facebook. I'm like, "Oh, you know, I saw the best yet post on Facebook." I'm like, "Oh, that's hard." Hour later, he's dead. That is crazy. Hour, 2 hours later, man, that's wild. That's wild. He actually was like a big supporter of mine. If you go back to my page, I'm gonna repost back like an updated version like later on this week. It's like, if you go on my page, you see like his past interview with me, and he learned about his brand. And where he comes from and what he cares about, what he thinks, you know, you should do as a businessman. And he actually was, he came to my talent show. And I was surprised when I saw him. I was like, "Hey, like, damn, what the hell? You came to my talent show." Like, I was like surprised to see him there. I was so honored and happy to have him there. It meant the world. I remember thinking that too when I saw him. Like, you know, like, you being here means a lot. It means a lot that you were. Like, everything is like perfect. Like, you here is perfect. Perfect. Good guy. Good family man. But yeah, if you want to go check him out on my page, or you can go check him out. You know, so if you can search on Facebook, you see some things. Quentin Jackson. All right, y'all. Thank y'all for tuning in. You will learn more about HBCU. If some videos on my page, you can go look at my short film. I think I can link it on her. I don't know. I'll try to. Don't rate me on it, I'll try to. I thank y'all for tuning in. Make sure you press that subscribe button, press the also like, and share it if you like to. I appreciate it. I'll see y'all next time.